Garnet is a series of isostructural nesosilicate minerals, which means it is a silicate with all the silica tetrahedrons isolated and are only bonded together by metal ions which lie between them. Its name stems from the Latin word granatus, which means like a grain. Garnets are named so because of their grainy physical properties, which we shall see later. The chemical composition of garnet is X3Y2SiO4O3, where X is a divalent metallic ion of iron, calcium, magnesium or manganese. Y is a trivalent metallic ion, which may be aluminium, iron, chromium. So in composition, garnets are essentially silicates of various divalent and trivalent metals. Garnets have a moderately high specific gravity of 3.5 to 4 and are hard minerals with a hardness of 7.5 on the Mohs scale. They have a vitreous luster, conchoidal fracture and do not have any cleavage. Garnets only crystallize in cubic crystal system. These minerals are notable in having a strong power of crystallization and typically form compact crystals. Garnet crystallizes in two crystal forms, rhombo-dodecahedron made up of 12 rhomb-shaped faces or trapezohedron made up of 24 trapezoid-like faces. Let us now see some of the minerals of the garnet family. The garnet group is subdivided into six principal species, which represent the end members of an isomorphous series. These six subspecies are put into two groups, the aluminium garnet group or the calcium garnet group. The aluminium silicate garnets have the end members pyrope, almandine, and spessartine, and that is why this group is also called the pyral spike group. A garnet of the entire composition of these end members only is rare, and the name to the garnet is assigned according to the dominant molecular type present. Notice that all pyrozoites have aluminium and silica common in them. The calcium silicate garnets have the end members of uvarovite, grossular and andradite, and together these subspecies are called the ugrandite group. Notice again that all of these minerals have calcium and silica common in them. Let's explore the end members along with learning about their occurrences. Here in the images, we see microscopic and macroscopic view of garnetiferous mica schists. Garnets form under high temperature and pressure and are common in highly metamorphized rocks. Pyrope occurs in ultra-basic igneous rocks such as peridotites. Its color depends on the solid solution and it is deep red to nearly black. Almandine is an extremely common mineral in metamorphic rocks. Its color is deep red to purplish due to the presence of iron, and this color is often regarded as the characteristic garnet color. Spessartine is a rare garnet and is mostly found in granites and pegmatites. It ranges in color from red-brown to yellow-brown, and its orange occurrence is a gemstone. Coming to the ugrandite group, the green color of andradite stems from the presence of chromium impurities. Andradite occurs in igneous and metamorphic rocks and is also common in limestone that have undergone contact metamorphism through the above reaction. Good specimens of grossular usually come from metamorphized limestone, where calcium is abundant and iron is absent. Grossular is usually green, but it may also be colorless to yellow. That grossular mineral may also be hydrated, and then it is called hydrogrossular. Hydrous garnets may contain H2O up to 8.5%. Uvarovite has a brilliant emerald green color, which comes from the chromium ion. Uvarovite is found in serpentines rich in chromite. There are also several uses of garnet minerals. Garnets have no cleavage, and unlike minerals calcite or fluorite, garnet form sharp ragged pieces when crushed. They also have hardness of 7, which makes them a good mineral abrasive. Also, the finest specimens of garnets are used as gemstones. Almandine of gem variety is found in northern India and Sri Lanka. Thanks for watching.